Alright guys, so I have quite a few projects going on, or planned, and my first one for today will be to install a mast light at the top of the mast to be safe and secure when I'm at anchor. So let's try that. First thing first, I think I don't want to climb up there and do all this in a ladder, so I'll bring the mast down close to the garage. Good, so now that the mast is off the boat and on these support, I'm gonna take off this end. I know most of the work I'll have to do is from the other end, because from what I saw in blogs and various places, there's a lot of foam at the top part of the mast to help the MacGregor right itself up if ever you were to flip it. And I think about halfway down the mast, I believe, from what I could see, all the way about up to this point, there is a foam at the bottom. I'm gonna have to push a rod through this foam and find a solution to run the wire all the way up. But I'll take this off first and look from this end. So taking the base off the mast is, I've done it before to grease up the bearing. And very easy, you take off this screw that runs from one side to the other, and this small screw holds it aligned. And that's pretty much all that holds this in place. There you go, so the plate is off. As I said, one large bolt and one small self-tap screw is all that's holding the base here. So let's have a look inside. I'm gonna use this pretty powerful light to try to see in there. Here we go, squeeze in. Alright, so what I see is one bolt close to me and one bolt all the way up. Redirect this all the way up, and then the foam starts. So that means I could see basically this bolt, I see the wires coming up to here, I see that bolt, and then foam somewhere around here with what I'm assuming might be a plate or something that holds it there. I'm not sure if what I'm seeing is actual foam or any type of metallic plate, so time will tell, but obviously I expected to do this job from the top of the mast, and that's where I'm going. So at the very top of the mast, I have this is for my wind vane and the block here, a pulley to hoist raise the sail with the halyard. And from there I could tell, like, I'll obviously have to remove this cap, hopefully be able to reuse it to mount my mast light here, and if not, I'll have to find another cap here. So let's drill those rivets out. Right, it was pretty easy to take out, and I think I'll be able to reuse the cap. That's great news. And in here, obviously, might be a bit of spare room on the right side to run the wire without pushing too much of the foam out of there. So let's see if I could just push a wire through there. So from what I could tell, the foam should be give or take 18 feet of foam to push through, and up to this here is 24 feet. So that's probably about 30 feet. Yeah. 30 feet is the mast full length, but the concern, the part I'm concerned about is more obviously where I have to push through the foam. So I bought this set here, which basically gives me 33 feet of running kit, and this is especially made to push or pull a wire, but I'm interested in pushing through the foam, so let's give that a try. Obviously gonna start small and fish guide the wire, guide the string through there so that I could pull on the electrical wire after that, because I don't want to push a heavy thick wire with this pretty flimsy pole, but it should do the trick for that guide wire. So far so good, almost zero resistance, and seems to be as easy as cleaning my chimney, because I have a large pole that works pretty much exactly like that to clean the chimney on my house. So let's see if that brings me all the way to the bottom. This is turning out so far easier than I expected. But let's not jinx it. Alright. Success. Alright. This is great. But this took me 4 minutes, I would say. But that's the best purchase. If something worth 25 bucks could save me a couple of hours sometimes to struggle and push and grind and whatever, I thought I would have to destroy part of the foam in the mast, and nope, just using this. I actually thought I would have to push through the foam to make a way for the rod, and there was just enough space near the sail slide all the way down here. Alright, so I tied this up, and this wire is probably an overkill for a mast light, I realize that, but it's what I have, and at least I'm gonna make sure it's not gonna corrode or anything else like that, because it's marine rated. So let's bring that up the mast. So I started to pull from the base of the mast, and something was catching. I don't know what it was, but I figured maybe it's best I start from the very top and align it in the foam where I could see it instead of the bottom. So I'll try that instead, and hopefully we'll get this wire through. So it pulled through quite easily until I reach a certain point, and I guess that point seemed to be this here. Oh, it went through. Oh yes, my god, it was pretty close here. Excellent, got it through. Yeah, even the dogs are happy, for sure. Well, that's great, guys. I'm very happy about that. I was a bit afraid that there was a plate of some kind holding this foam. But I guess the foam is just in there. And it holds in place with the pressure, I guess, it has inside the mast. Anyhow, I won't try to guess how Mr. McGregor built this, but I'm happy. And so I'll leave myself enough wire for some play here. I'm replacing this wire as well, so it's going to come out of here, and basically it just needs enough to plug into the deck, so that's obviously more than enough, even too much, but that's fine. And as luck has it, if you're like me, when you do a project, sometimes project leads to another one. So I took this light out because I wanted to replace this wire at the same time. And so I will, of course, replace this wire that's original. But I thought, okay, maybe I should replace this lamp as well with the model that has the mast head and the deck lamp, which means two switches instead of one inside, which is fine. So I'm thinking I'll replace this old mast head lamp with a better model LED, because this is not LED. For having two different satellites and the mast light. So I'll keep my guide wire for this second job here. So when I went shopping for this project, I wanted to replace the deck plug at the same time. And I got this nice looking deck plug. The first, so there's some two wires, three wires, and I found out some four wire. And I took the four wire in case I upgrade something at one point, and sure enough, here I am adding a third light, which means three wire and one for ground. So these, everything I guess I have in the mast will share one wire per light, and one they'll share the same ground up in the mast, and there'll be switches inside the boat. That's my plan anyway. So if you're like me, you probably bust your thumbs trying to jam some wires in these conduits to protect the wires. So I found this little trick on YouTube, gotta love YouTube. Just a simple coat on here, you make a loop and you bury this in the channel there. I could get that right. Here we go. And then it's just a matter of pulling it and the wires. And right now it's a bit harder than usual because I'm doing three wires in one pass. If you're making just one wire, much easier. And also, obviously this channel is quite tight. It's pretty much made for 2 to 3 wires. And so it's pretty much full. It's time to part with this old thing. There you go. Alright, so I'm gonna pull back on the old wire and run and use it to run my guide wire for the next. I'm just gonna might as well run brand new wires. These are over 10 years old, might still be good, but for the length of it, I don't want any trouble later, so I'll change them all because I need to have 3 wires anyway. There you go. Good. And the rest of this I'll remove once it's through. Let's try that. I'll give it a head start. Okay. Let's see. Because I was afraid that this part here with the vibration might potentially cut the new wires. The old ones weren't protected, but I want the new one to be protected. So there it is. Here we go. So before I cut the cable, I pulled quite a bit more. And that's because a little trick I found just recently, you put some zip tie like this around the electrical cable inside the mast. And I know I have foam up to here, so I don't need to go all the way up. But to avoid this annoying noise that some people call the tattoo noise, you put these zip ties, a couple of them, and once this goes in, when I pull it back in, it's gonna basically hold the cable and avoid the back and forth motion of the cable that could do that annoying noise when you're at anchor or at the marina or whatever.
So I have 2 ground wire, and now I want to merge them into one so that the only one wire goes into that new plug.
Right, so now the 2 grounds are connected with the single ground that's going to go to the plug. I like to heat shrink everything together like this as far as the grounds are together, and then I will heat shrink the whole wire together with a larger shrink tube here. That's pretty good. I'm not quite there yet, so I want to make a second heat shrink all the way on top of the whole original tubing. So I'll just cut some of that and double shrink this on top of the whole thing.
The reason I do that is because I had to cut the protection sleeve around the marine grade wire to merge the grounds together. Now I want to replace everything and put it back waterproof.
Good. So I'm done wrapping this in loom protection, and I reduced the diameter as much as I could after the connection I made here, but that's still too big to come out of the original hole, so I'll just make this a bit of a wider hole with this here. I'll make sure I'm not drilling through my wires. Good to go. So this part is done. I chose to leave the hard plastic wrap here and convert into a regular shrink wrap, but I won't install the deck plug here, or the plug that's going to go in the deck, until I'm on the boat, just to make sure I have the exact length I need. So now let's go and install the actual anchor light. Great, so it's time to install the mast, the anchor light, into the cap. And pretty sure this cap I'll be able to reinstall, so I'll use the same one. I'll just drill a small hole in the center here for those wires, and it's gonna go like this.
So anytime I do an electrical job, it doesn't matter if it's around the house or on the boat or on the vehicle, anytime I get close to a switch or a connection point, I leave a bit of spare wire. This is to help me if ever I need to go back in there in the future and fix something. Nothing worse than having a tiny little bit of wire to play with. So that's my way to resolve that. So the rest is pretty straightforward. Strip the wires, put some quality butt connection on there, and shrink wrap every wire to avoid moisture and corrosion, and this connection is pretty much done. Now I'll reinstall the cap. And as you saw, when I removed the cap, it was held by rivets. So I'll do the same thing with quality aluminum or stainless steel rivets. So it's time to figure out how to mount this new light. The rivets won't be at the same place, so I'll have to figure that out. So I decided to help the bend on this new plastic there on the light by heating it up a little bit and giving it a bit of a curve before I try to muscle it into place on the mast. I guess you know by now that I like to heat shrink everything to avoid moisture. So I need to drill for new rivets, and I'm quite happy with the results.
Right, so everything is back together, ready to put back on the boat. So let me know if this was useful, guys. That's my first video I do like this, and I thought might as well shoot it and maybe help others like I wish I had before I started a few projects. So once I go back, put the mast back on the boat, I'll finish this wiring to the correct length. I'm thinking it's going to be about a foot, but I want to make sure, so I'll finish this right on the boat. And maybe I'll do another video if you guys enjoy this one for the rest of the job, putting the plug back on the deck, changing the deck plug, and also putting the switches in the boat to operate these new lights. So ciao for now, and let me know in the comments if this was useful, and if you would have done anything differently. I'm also here to learn, for sure. Cheers.